everyone, it's Lottie from Cancer is a Lifestyle. So as you guys can tell by the title of this vlog, I am going to be joining in the Crocheting Community's challenge of the movie and Stitch. They started this back in January, so I mean it is March, you guys. I am a little late with this. I have not seen this. Actually, I don't know what was I doing that I did not see the challenge from the beginning. So basically what you're doing is going through the whole alphabet, A through Z, and every 2 weeks you post a movie based on the letter of the alphabet. You start with A, so the first week, yeah, you do a movie that begins with the letter A. The next time around, you do a movie that begins with the letter B, until you work your way through the whole alphabet. They're posting every 2 weeks, and also while they're doing and watching the movie, they are also working on a project. So I am really late, you guys, and like I said, I don't know what I was doing. Probably in my winter blues moment, you know, just feeling sorry for myself. For the lack of sunshine, but I'm going to join in. We have over like 350 different movies here at home. I mean, at least we've ended up getting an organizer to, and I took all the CDs and I put them in the organizer because it would take up so much room, and just getting rid of all the covers was just open up a lot of space. So I would suggest that if you have a lot of DVDs or you have a lot of CDs and all, just go ahead and get an organizer on Amazon. Those things are fabulous, and you carry everything. A lot of them carry like up to 400. So anyway, I have decided to choose a movie for Atonement. Now, I saw this movie originally in the movie theater. It came out in 2008. And you would say, well, why would you go back and watch it again? Let me tell you something about myself. And my daughter pointed this out when I said I was going to do this challenge. One, I get lost in the movie. When the movie is playing, I am all up in that movie. It's like I'm living that life that they're portraying. I am right there with them, going through that experience. So I also have a habit. Like this, I haven't seen this since 2008, which is like, what, 13 years ago? Well, you guys, I will get, you know, it's like I'm watching the movie all over again. Like I forget scenes, I forget things that happen, I have an idea of what goes on. There's even things that I've forgotten. Like I'm totally looking at a movie like I've never seen it before. That is a problem I have. This is why I'm afraid of Alzheimer's, because you know I don't remember like a lot of these movies. Like you know, there's a lot of things that I'm watching. It's like, oh, I forgot. Like, you know, which drives my daughter crazy. Which is why she was like, why would you do this challenge when you get so involved? And you act like you've never seen it before, that how are you going to be working on a project? Which is true, because I always have my crocheting near me, but I don't always work on it religiously throughout the movie. So let me tell you about the movie Atonement. If you have not been, if you are not familiar with that movie, it came out in 2008. It starred Keira Knightley and James McAvoy. That his name? I mean, I know his face so well. It was a movie that had a twist. It was a period movie, which I think it was done like in the 1920s. Am I right to think that? It was a rich family that was Keira, and it was a love story between a young lady, Keira, and the poor young man, James McAvoy. And it was told in the eyes of her younger sister, who was 13 years old. And she was so jealous of this relationship that they had, because she had feelings for James McAvoy herself as a 13-year-old, that she accuses him of a crime that he did not commit. And because he was a poor man, young man, he ends up going to prison. So you know right there, that story, the love story's taking a dive, and you know, you're getting out the hanky, and oh my gosh. Yeah, it's that kind of a movie. So if this movie is told by her as an older lady now. Now she's a senior lady, she's an elderly lady, she becomes a writer, and she writes this story because, as the title of the movie says, Atonement, there is a lot of guilt she is feeling for separating this a love affair, and this young man goes to prison. So a lot of things go on into this movie, but I will tell you, and I'm not going to tell you the ending because it has a twist to it, and I don't want to give it away, but it's her decision that affects everyone's life in that household. And it's a really good movie. But like I said, I get so involved. You guys, I am one of those people that is on the edge of my seat all the time. And I could be crocheting, I could be doing, but I will not be crocheting nonstop. So, which leads me to what am I going to be working on? Well, I went back and forth because I know I am not going to be working on this project religiously. I'm going to be glued to the set like I've never seen the movie, you know, because this is how I am. Whatever movie I'm going to be watching. And of course, that's the very thing that happened, because I'm going to show you how much I got done. So I decided to work on my homeless mats. Now, I know that it's a little different than what everyone else is doing. Everyone is crocheting, or they're doing Tunisian, crocheting. They're, you know, working on project. I'm going to be crocheting homeless mats. So here's the one I started, and it's kind of wide. This is how much I got done. And even though they work up really fast, like I said, I get involved when I'm watching something. But I chose this for a reason. I don't want to be starting, no matter what project you're going to start, you're going to have to start several projects. Because if you think about every 2 weeks they're posting a video and they're watching a movie, you know, you're going to finish that project, and you're going to probably do a couple projects during the A through Z, you know. I want to work on the same thing. So even if I finish this, I'll be starting another homeless mat. And the second thing is, I don't really work on these mats for too long. Because anytime I use a large hook, which I am using a large hook, my hand hurts. So that affects, and I can't sit there for hours on end working on a project, or for days on end. I can only work on it for so long and then put it down, because my hand will really hurt. It will hurt my hand right here really bad. Yeah, it will shoot up to my arm. For some reason, anytime I'm using a large hook, it just affects me like that. So I think this is a good project to start, because I'll be only crocheting for that. You know, how long is the movie? An hour and a half. Tops, right? An hour and 10 minutes. And even then, I won't be doing it nonstop. And then I'll put it down until the next week, you know, or two. Right now, I'm going to be doing it every week until I get caught up, which I'm on A, they're on E. So think about that. I wrote it down. Yeah, so I'm going to have to go, it's going to take me, I think, the end of April that I'll be all caught up with them, which is not really that much, you know, or maybe even earlier. We'll see. Maybe I'll do every 5 days. But anyway, that's what I'm working on. If you are doing this, if you are joining in the fun, let me know what you guys have been watching. I have been trying to watch everyone else's. I believe that you do not have to be a crocheter to join in the fun. You could do any kind of project. I could see people doing artwork. I could be, journals, whatever. Because the whole point is to just do a fun twist, with our crocheting, with our crafts in general. Because sometimes we get into a rut and we want to do something new, you know, and everybody join in. And I said I would try to join in a lot of these new challenges, because I've just never done these things before. So anyway, that's all I got. I hope you will give Atonement a try. If you haven't, if you have, let me know what you thought of the movie. I cannot even honestly review a lot of these movies because, you know what? Like I said, I get so involved that even if it's a bad movie, I just get so involved in these things, and I am emotionally vested. But this was a little bit, you know, like a broken love story. There is a twist at the end. And if you've not seen it, I cannot tell you because I don't want to, like, give it away. But anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.